Good morning. So, where were we yesterday? So, we were in the middle of implementing our EditGoal API in the little Go backend server. Flip-flopping between how we're going to do it, how the API is going to look. But left ourselves a couple of to-dos. So we need to get and check a goal and then actually use the update goal function that we created, which is up here. And I need to fix up this SQL actually. So I need to format it. So we have I think we'll definitely have to do some tests at some point, because if I hadn't noticed that, we would have had all kinds of problems. I haven't done any testing in Go yet, so that'll be interesting. So our update goal takes a transaction, a bunch of params, including the member there. It's going to run update goal set, and then all the values, including updated at. And then it's simply going to return nothing if successful. Otherwise, an error. I'm not a huge fan of that. It would be nice to have a positive result. Okay, we'll keep it for the moment. Okay, so yeah. All right, let's do a little bit of validation and check in here. So we also need a get goal. To kind of validate that it works as intended. So how will we do that? A little function, because we're going to probably need to do this quite often. We've got do that though. Well, I don't suppose we need to do it right at the beginning. just no, we should. Well, we need to do it at some point, but it's just whether I bother doing it right this minute. Okay, let's just get this update working, and then we'll... So, we are passing in transaction. The r dot... goal ID. What else do we need up here? ID, verb, value, prefix, suffix, end date, and reason. That's probably complaining about overwriting, isn't it? So let's double check that we've got all the right params. Got the ID, member, verb, value, prefix, suffix, end date, and reason. We're going to do it. If it doesn't work, we're going to roll back, return nil and the error. Otherwise, I'm going to try and commit it. And we are we were saying that we're going to return the goal and measurements. I still don't know whether I should do that or not. Okay, let's assume we are. That means we need to go get measurements. And then we're returning the goal, which we haven't got yet, and the measurements. I'm still in two minds on that. I'm always going to get the measurements if they're missing anyway. So could leave it for the moment. Could then just set it as an option later. Let's do that. Need to update the definition. Okay. take this as a template for a get goal. Stick it here for the moment, but I'm going to have to rearrange this. We'll call it read. And it's going to return generated goal. Error. Yeah. I don't need to do this in a transaction, do I? So that's fine. Nope, that's my garage again. 1 second. And we're back from it. The problem with being in an office right next to my garage is if my wife needs to grab something from the garage, you get lots of noise. Okay. Right, we're going to change this then. I'm going to pass in ID. And the member ID. Or do we? Maybe I should check that. That should be separate. We'll do that as a validation check to make sure we get back an ID which matches rather than using it as part of the query. Because this is going to be quite low level. The ID, don't need an order by, I'm going to do a query row. which has slightly different syntax, isn't it? How have I done that before? Let's try and keep it consistent. Just a scan. Okay. Bit easier to read. Don't know whether that'll survive a. Oh, no, yeah, it doesn't like that. It's weird. Can I not do that? See you in a minute. Right, so we want into let's get a goal. We need to create a goal. No, that's just remember the syntax for that. Oh, I've got to just do that, haven't I? Because it's down there. So we get rid of all this in a minute. I'll just get rid of it now. And stick some of this up there. Guess that's not really needed, but it sets the record. The body, verb, value, prefix, suffix, end date, reason, created that, updated that. Now, I do not want a fatal here. It's not part of the API. I'm going to get rid of a load of those fatals, actually. That was all part of just early development. Don't actually want the binary to die. Just want it to return an error. So, we will return. Oops. Can't type spawn in. Okay. Actually, I wonder if, can I just do nil there? What's it going to complain? Yeah. So we've scanned an end date, created that and updated that, setting them to their Unix versions, and we return. Okay. Yeah, okay. So we're going to read a goal. I wonder what that would do. And an empty one. I guess we'll find out later. Might have to do a little check for that. Okay, so we're going to assume we've got the goal, and if the goal.member is not equal to r.member, okay, how do I generate a new error? Have I done that before? I presume it's new error. Nope. I've handled errors yet. Oh, I might have in main though. That would be, I'm just fatally in there. Okay, well, this is new stuff for me. So, I'm just gonna assume I can throw something like I just do return goal new. It doesn't look right. Runtime error. I wonder if it'll be. Error dot. Oh, there is an error. Okay, I probably need to go look at the docs. Here we go. Oops. Here it is. So new. Let's see if it looks easy enough. I've definitely done that before. Right. I have, I'm sure. Errors dot. No, apparently not. Okay. Invalid. Should I prefix with that? Nah. Let's just do invalid. I'll just do that for the moment. Because why not? And why is that going nuts? Hmm. Yes. Thanks. Huh. Well, that's a new one. Sure, I can do nail now then. Yeah. All right. That's all the checking we're going to do for the moment. We can do more later. In fact, I'm going to change that. It's not very helpful. It's a bit better. All right, then we do the update. And if it fails, do the thing, return the goal. Okay. I'm so surprised I haven't used Evers yet. It's dead weird. Mind you, I've not done much in this going and stuff at all, so. Okay, right. We've updated the service. Let's just do a quick make. Okay, it's not deployed though, because we need to do, and we haven't got time. What I was going to say is we need to do the client-side stuff now. What's really getting me is that I haven't got any testing at all on this Go stuff. And it would probably go a lot quicker if I had, like, okay, red-green tests. It might formulate the API a bit quicker as well. So I might look into that. Might do a little bit of research and see if I can do that. The problem I expect I'll have is testing when you're doing database stuff is a complete pain. So I might need to basically mock up a bunch of stuff. I don't like doing mocks, but we might need to do that. Anyway, right, I've got to go. So until next time, take care.